So I'm having issues with Chillie, specifically with her starter. So I think the one-way bearing is worn because sometimes she just doesn't want to start, or, you know, sort of like what, it just doesn't sound right when she starts. So we're gonna have to investigate this. So I booked an appointment with a mechanic in the city, which is like, what, 230 kilometers from here. So we'll see how we go. I mean, if I'm not sure the guy is gonna have the time to fix it or to get the parts on time, because I'm sort of need to speed up a bit. But at least I know what's going on and I know what parts I need to order, and maybe I'll fix it in another time. We'll see how we go. Anyway, the good thing is someone's gonna have a look at it and see how much damage there is. I think I'm like, I've got this like frozen position on the bike, so it's only 35 kilometers left and I haven't stopped. I can't stop because I think I want to be able to get back on the bike. So I'm just like, yeah, frozen on the bike. Keep going. Let's just keep going, get there as soon as possible. I made it to Moncton, safe and sound. Oh my god, I'm cold. Right. 500 meters to our mechanic. He's a cake. And the rain haven't stopped even for 1 second. No. On the BMW motorcycle service. That's us. I'm guessing. Motorcycle, yeah, that's a small sign. No wonder. Like here? I guess so. Yeah, that's like a little. Hello. Made it!
Oh shit.
A bit wet.
You're all wet. How long have you been on the road?
Like 2.5 hours?
I know you.
You do?
Well, from your YouTube.
Thank you.
Okay.
That's a nice garage.
Whoa.
I hit my camera. Sorry.
The camera's still on, by the way.
Yes, I know. I'm recording. You don't mind?
Oh, no. Go right ahead.
Hi, Kinga.
Yeah.
That's the way. What's your name?
Luciano.
I've spoken to you.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Yesterday. That's you.
That's
Luciano.
Right.
Very good.
Tell me your name again.
Kinga.
Spell it.
It's a king with an A.
Kinga.
Yeah.
Okay.
Too
easy.
Easy
to remember. I wasn't sure if I was hearing a K at the beginning or was it just Inga, but
yeah, no, it's like Inga with K at the beginning. Christ! Oh, that was my hair.
Fantastic.
Hold on, I'll wipe your camera.
I don't have that issue.
Hold on, I'll wipe you more. Hello, hello, YouTube. This is Luciano. Unfortunately, Luciano cannot help me today because with my starter, because we have no parts and it's gonna take a long time to arrange it all, so I've decided to keep going regardless. It was very nice to meet you.
It's been a pleasure to have you in the space, and I recognize you as soon as you pulled into the
yard. I know.
I was like, I know you.
Yes, well, very nice to meet you.
Likewise.
It's a shame I can't hang out more at your shop, but yeah, thank you
Adrian
for the great conversation.
Cycle Service.
That's right. Yeah. Okay, and now it's time to go to Airbnb and put some dry clothes on.
Get warm.
She starts all right now.
I fixed it.
That's it. Okay, so yeah, we couldn't fix Chillie there because I'm aware that it's not an easy job, and now she starts all right, but yeah, definitely I need to fix it. I don't know, within a week or two, because I don't want to get stuck later on somewhere in remote parts of Canada. But anyway, now we are going to our Airbnb. This is a nice town. I think it's on the corner there. I'm so cold. Here. Mad sleep, that's right. Okay. And the entry is... I have to read the instructions, but it's somewhere in this house. Morning, everyone. We are going now to the hairdresser. Got up super early because I managed to book myself in with a hairdresser just around the corner. I have to use this opportunity because I'm totally overdue. Right. Today we have a nice, beautiful, sunny day. I think we're here. Right. I don't know. Parking for who? Okay, reserved. Well, I guess here it's not reserved, right, Chillie? That's a good spot for you. Stay. I'll be back soon. Okay. Quickly. Hello, how you going? Sorry, I'm a little bit late. You're doing great job.
Thank you.
Nearly there.
Almost.
You guys never guess what happened. So someone came inside and said someone was trying to nick stuff from my bike. So, sorry, what was your name?
Oh, Laura.
Laura. So Laura and I were going to check it out.
So where did you go? Right there?
Someone was trying to, apparently, get my... So yeah, unpack there.
So I would park over here. Like, this is where we usually park.
Yeah, okay, I'll move it to there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you sure you don't want to take the paint off?
Huh? Maybe I'll give this to you because I'm going to lose it. This is going to be cool. I'll keep it on.
Yeah.
Do you mind coming with me for a second? Ooh, how's my head? It was locked.
It was locked.
This one's got two locks on it.
The my one was locked. How the fuck did they open it? They lock everything.
Fuck. This one's open, but there's
all my camping gear.
So the first time we chased them away that way, he just happened to notice on the cameras one of our guys were upstairs ran down. He threw his stuff there, and I think he was able to put some of it back, but then the guy came back and chased him away, and he fucked off that way.
I have to go to the police. Oh my fucking... This is like $1,000 all over.
So I don't know why your two locks are here.
Because I locked this yesterday. Why the how the fuck did I unlock it?
I don't know if it's maybe on the wrong.
No, this no. This one is not working. This one is working.
Well, I don't know. When I was upstairs, one of the guys says, I don't know whose bike that is, but we just chased somebody way twice.
Right, so first time, for the very first time in my life, I got robbed. Here in Canada, of all the places, right? 5 years on the road and nothing was ever stolen from me until today. I'm fuming right now, sorry, you might not tell, but all I want to say is F words. Anyway, all these bikes were open. I don't know, have no idea how the hell did they crack the lock, because I had just put a new lock to the other bag. This one is an old one, but this one clearly did. Couldn't get to this one, but they've opened the other one. See, I had this sort of lock on the other side, and then just like the lock is gone. Well done, seriously. This bag empty, everything gone. This bag empty, everything gone. Half of the stuff in this bag is gone, half of it only. They only took the ones from the bottom, from the top. Oh good, I've got some extra straps. Okay, well that's nice, we left it there. So all my camping gear, all my kitchen, all my chain loop tools, stove, everything. Chillie, what happened to you today? Jesus, I can't camp anymore, I can't fix my bike anymore, I'm fuming. So anyway, there's a camera here on this building. I'm gonna go there, ask for the footage, and I'm gonna have to go to the police station, report it all. So yes, this hair visit, hairdressing appointment was quite pricey. Can't believe this happened to me. I mean, if I lived in Canada, safe country, I felt so safe here all this time. Right, so I'm back to my Airbnb. Spent a few hours just going to the police station and going back to where it happened, and now I have to write a big report to the police men what exactly happened. We have a footage. It was actually quite funny how the guy really took his time to take everything out, and yeah, without a worry, just like that, on the other parking where just like so many cars are parked. But luckily for him, no one was actually walking next to it. So they might find him, they may not find him. I just said, from the top of my head, I only know there will be around over 2,000 of gear that was stolen. So all my camping gear, all my tools, spare parts, that sort of stuff. And so yeah, I'm not happy. I don't even know how I'm gonna travel now through Canada. I can't afford to stay in hotels. I need my camping gear. Anyway, I think it's a problem for tomorrow, because I am now emotionally exhausted. And tomorrow will be another day. I'm just going to have a drink now. Yes, and write a report to the police.